What is up? My name is Matt Workman for Cinematography Database, and in this video, I wanted to share some of the new types of tech in virtual reality that I've been playing with, and they pair really well with Cine Designer. So, what we're looking at here is a really weird statue, right? Really odd, and I created this really quickly inside of something called Oculus Medium, which is a virtual reality creation program. And all of those words sound really scary, but funny enough, virtual reality and creating things in virtual reality is much easier and more intuitive than creating them in the traditional way, which would be like in Cinema 4D. Okay, so here we are in Oculus Rift, and I'm gonna open up a program called Oculus Medium. And what it allows you to do is to actually create things in 3D in VR. On our hands here, we can see them, and on the back here is a grip, and if you hold the grip, it allows you to move things around. And if you do both hands at once, grip at once, you can push them together, so it's kind of like a 3D pinch and zoom. And the other thing is that you have triggers on the back, and these are your pointer fingers here. You'll see a little green sphere here. If I push the trigger, it's going to make that sphere into a piece of clay. So ready? Pretty cool, right? So I'm gonna use my left hand and I'm gonna grip and start spinning this object, pushing the trigger, making a little ball, make a little ball, spin. And this is pretty much like if you had a little ball of clay here and you were spinning this object around. And what we were doing before was painting with basically spheres, and you could do cubes, you could do a pill, but you could also go to stamps. And this is the fun part, and I think what makes it a little bit more realistic for people is if you go to something called rocks. I did a demo like this before. If you take something like this, you shake to go away. Now I have that block in my 3D hand here. Place it, place it, place it, place it. And then I can grab it and I can look at it. So it's just like the real world here, except everything floats and you have an infinite number of these, more or less. So I suggest if you want to try this and follow along after, go into the menu over here, hit the green button, go back into stamps, click stamps, and go look through this little menu of all this different stuff. So let's go to human anatomy here, kind of interesting. And let's grab, is this a foot? Push the right trigger up to make it bigger, down to make it smaller. So let's make it like this, right? So this is what, a right leg, left leg? I don't know. But let's put this leg here. One click, this. Very cool. I feel like there has to be a body here. Here's the body. Okay, great. A little bit smaller here, a little bit bigger, like this. Boom. Let's put a big old head on this thing. Let's make it big. Let's make it like a cartoon head. This is gonna be the nightmares of your dreams here, but there's a whole bunch of tools, and we've been using the clay tool. There's a whole bunch of other things to do here, but the main one I want to show you is paint. And paint, like you would imagine, is like a little paintbrush. So if I do this by default, it looks like it's gonna be red. If I push the trigger, I can now paint this stuff. So no texturing, no UVing. You're just straight painting it like you would in the real world. A little color palette button here. And now you can choose a color. Again, really intuitive. Let's see if we can pick a skin color. And we have a skin tone, so let's make a naked person, right? And we're just spraying this thing. And I'm gonna show you how to export this into Cinema 4D. So we're gonna go to this little yellow button here, and I'm going to say save. And you can do this funny keyboard here and save it. I'm gonna just hit enter. Yellow button again. Let's do export. 100% is fine. We're gonna do textures. We're gonna do PNG and also select OBJ and FBX. Pretty good. Let's up the texture to 4K, the size of it, and then we hit export. Okay, so we're in Cinema 4D, and let's go actually get that model that we are documents. It's gonna be under medium, sculpts, your username, and then I believe this is the latest one here, OBJ, right here, and I'm going to bring it in. So we have the sculpture we made in Oculus Medium. It has the color that we wanted from it there. And now what we're able to do inside of Cinema 4D with Redshift, we can actually photograph this virtually. So I'm gonna focus on this, and it focuses on the head, and the front arm is out of focus, and the back arm is out of focus here too. It's really up to you what you want. This pairs really great with Cine Designer, and I have a whole YouTube channel called Cinematography Design dedicated to teaching the really detailed specifics needed to do this type of work, especially for planning for real world shoots. So that wraps it up for this video. I know it's not like strict cinematography stuff, it's more of a 3D workflow, but I'm working a lot more in virtual reality, and I believe that there's a lot of applications for virtual reality, for filmmakers, for virtual production, for previs, and this is some of the stuff that I've been experimenting with, so I wanted to share this with you if this seemed like something that you wanted to check out. If you like the video, give the video a like, subscribe to the channel. We do more normal filmmaking things on this channel here, but this is kind of a cool new tech thing that I've been playing with. And VR sculpting and VR filmmaking is something that I'm going to be doing just a little bit more this year. So until next time, you guys get out there and plan better, shoot better.